wings will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord our God. Lord, you reign forever. Our hope, our strong deliverer.
Help me sing it.
You are the everlasting God. The everlasting God. You do not fade, you won't grow weary.
Your friends will let you down. Can't rely on the government anymore, but God is everlasting for your need this morning.
Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait on the Lord. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord our God. Lord, you reign forever. He reigns forever, our hope, our strong deliverer. God, you are the everlasting God.
Sing it to him.
The everlasting God. You do not fade, you won't grow.
God, you reign forever.
Our God, you reign forever. You reign forever.
Our hope, our strong deliverer.
Our strong deliverer.
Now sing it to him. Sing, you are.
You are the everlasting God. The everlasting God. Do not fade, you won't grow weary.
You're the defender of the weak.
You're the defender of the weak. Lord, and you comfort those in need. You lift us up on wings like.
Everlasting, amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. If no one's told you today they love you, I'm here to tell you Jesus loves you. No matter where you've been, no matter what you've done, we are loved by the King of Kings this morning.
There is an endless song. Echoes in my soul. I hear the music ring. And though the storms may come, I am holding on to the rock I cling. How can I keep from singing your praise? How can I ever say enough? How amazing is your love? How can I keep
from shouting your name. When I know I am loved by the King, and it makes my heart wanna sing. I will lift my eyes in the darkest night, for I know that my Savior, He lives. And I will walk with you, knowing you'll see me through, and sing the songs you give. Oh, how can I keep from singing your praise? How can I ever say enough? How amazing is your love? How can I keep from shouting your name? When I know I am loved by the King, and it makes my heart wanna sing. I like this. I can sing in the troubled times, sing when I win. I can sing when I lose my step and I fall down once or twice again. I can sing 'cause you pick me up, sing 'cause you're there. I can sing 'cause you hear me, Lord, when I call to you in prayer. I can sing with my last breath, sing for I know that I'll sing with the angels and the saints around the throne. How can I keep from singing your praise? How can I ever say enough? How amazing is your love? How can I keep from shouting your name when I know I am loved by the King? And it makes my heart, I am loved by the King, and it makes my heart. You are loved by the King, and it makes my heart wanna sing. We can sing in the good times, and we can sing when it rains. Come on, Jerry, help me on the piano. We'll song glad only when this life is o'er. Fly away. Sing it. To a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away. Sing it loud. For you more weary days, and then I'm gonna fly away to a land where joy shall never end. I'll fly away. Sing aloud. Well, I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away in the morning. Hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Come on, Jerry. Well, when the shadows of this life have gone, oh, I'm gonna fly away. listen to this powerful song. It's just a conversation between me and the Lord.
I betrayed, but you forgave. I ran away, still you stayed, and I lived a lie. You spoke the truth, now I'm undone with no excuse. I cursed your name, but you called me child. I was to blame, but you went to trial, and I lived to take. You died to give me more than I could ever find. And on my own, I made a mess of things. But you take it as my offering. You take the best and the worst of me, and peace is at your throne. Whether broken or made whole, and I can't imagine anything more beautiful or more amazing. When I bring everything, you take it as my offering. I'm full of doubt, but you're full of mercy. I come unwound, but you restore me. When I'm shaking like a leaf, you're the comfort that I need, that melts my fears away. And on my own, I made a mess of things, but you take it as my offering. You take the best and the worst of me, and peace is at your throne. Where the broken are made whole, and I can't imagine anything more beautiful or more amazing. When I bring everything, and you take it as my offering, yeah. My life has been an offering. I'm yours and yours alone. My life has been an offering. I'm yours, but you take it as my offering. You take the best and the worst of me, and peace is at your throne. Where the broken are made whole, and I can't imagine anything more beautiful or more amazing. When I bring as my offering, Jesus, you take it as my offering.
Thank you, Jesus.
Anyone who needs a touch of mercy, to anyone who stumbled and give up, just come to the fountain of forgiveness. You'll find wonder-working power in the blood. There's still wonder-working power in the blood of Calvary. Every day and every hour, still flows to make us free, and it's power still today to wash in away in that never-ending soul cleansing flood. There's still wonder-working power in the blood. For every time the tempter tries to harm you, for every time you stumbled and give up, praise God, there is a fountain of forgiveness. There's still wonder-working power in the blood. There's still wonder-working power in the blood of Calvary. Every day and every hour, it still flows to make us free. And it's powerful today to wash sin away in that never-ending soul-cleansing flood. There's still wonder-working power in the blood. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Yeah, there's still wonder-working power in the blood of Calvary. Every day and every hour, it still flows to make us free. And it's strong enough today to wash it away in that never-ending soul-cleansing flood. There's still wonder-working power in the blood. There's still wonder-working power. Wonder-working power. Wonder-working power in the blood.
They're true. He's everything he said he would be. And the finest words I know cannot begin to tell just what my Jesus is to me. For he's than my mind can conceive. He's more wonderful than my heart can believe. He goes beyond my highest hopes and fondest dreams. Yes, he's everything that he promised, and so much more.
More than amazing,
more than marvelous, more than miraculous could ever be. He's more than wonderful. That's what Jesus is. Stand amazed to think that the King of Glory would come to live within the heart of man.
Oh, I marvel just to know he really unsearchable than my mind can conceive. He's more wonderful than my heart can believe. He goes beyond my highest hopes and fondest dreams. Yes, he's everything,
that my soul ever longed for.
He's everything that he promised and so much more.
What Jesus is to me,
he is to me.
He's everything that my soul ever longed for.
He's
everything that he promised and so much more.
Well, I feel Jesus in there this morning, amen. I don't know what your need is, but I'm here to tell you he loves you and he can meet your need. I'm excited about Jamey being here. Most of you have never heard him, but I'm telling you, I have sung before some of the greatest preachers, Jerry Falwell, Mike Perkey, Johnny Hunt, some of the greatest, and I've never heard a better communicator of the gospel than Jamey ever in my life. And if you'll be open to what he has to say, I mean, you're going to laugh. We call him the comedialist because he's a comedian and an evangelist. So, but I'm telling you, I've never heard anyone like him, and I'm honored to be ministering with him a lot this year and into next year. And so I'm just going to do a couple more songs. I want to do this song. Can I do two more songs? Is that all right? Are y'all in a big hurry? I promise you'll beat the Methodist to the buffet bar today, all right? So, but can I do a new song? I'm recording a new album this coming week. I've got tracks done. Michael English is going to be on it, and Candy Christmas with the Hemp. Remember Candy Christmas? Yeah. She's not here this morning, but I mean, she's... and Michael Sykes is producing it, and I've got some really neat songs, and I love this. This is an old song, and... you might recognize it. If you like it, just let me know. And if you don't, just act like you do anyway. It's all right. But this is a different take on an old song. And hope you like it. Come on now.
There's a time that's coming. Coming very soon. Maybe I'm even morning or at noon.
I like this.
The union of the bride, united with the groom. We shall see the king when he comes. We shall see the king. We shall see the king.
If you know, help me.
We shall see the king when he comes. He's coming in power. We'll hail the blessed hour. We shall see the King when he comes. Oh, my brother, oh, my brother, should the Savior call today?
Will Jesus say, well done? The vow can never stay. We shall see the King when he comes.
Come on now, sing it.
We shall see the King. We shall see the King. We shall see the King when he comes. He is coming in power. We'll hail the blessed hour. The King when he comes.
This is where if I had a band, I'd turn around and tell them they were doing good, but I don't have a band today.
My sister, should the Savior call today? Will Jesus say, well done or go away? Oh, gonna crown him King of Kings and Lord of Lords. We shall see the King when he comes.
Do you believe that? I believe it soon. Come on.
We shall see the King. We shall see the King. We shall see the King when he comes. He's coming in power. We'll hail the blessed hour. We shall see the King when he comes. Oh, we shall see the King when he comes.
Yeah, yeah. It's gonna be soon, folks. He's coming back. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready to see? Amen. Thank you.
The hour is approaching when the soul of man will hear a mighty shout resounding in the sky. In power and great glory, King Jesus will appear to take his children home to paradise. It will be a celebration for the ones who chose his name. Total separation for the ones who turned away. Are you ready for the trumpet? Are you ready for the call? 'Cause soon the angels will assemble to usher in the Son of God. Will he come and find you faithful? Will he know it all? Every moment brings us closer. Are you ready for the call? The Bible speaks of two men. They're standing in a field. One is taken, the others left behind. Two women in the kitchen. One goes and one remains. So get your house
in order while there's still time. For in the cross there is salvation. Through his blood there is a way to secure your destination on that resurrection day. Are you ready for the trumpet? Are you ready for the call? 'Cause soon the angels will assemble to usher in the Son of God. Will he come and find you faithful? Will he know your name at all? Every moment brings us closer. Are you ready for the call? Listen, there's an urgency to reach the world. We have no time to wait, for within the heart soon the angels will assemble to usher in the Son of God. Will he come and find you faithful? Will he know your name at all? Every moment brings us closer. Are you ready for the call? Oh, will he come? Thank you. Thank you so much.
I was allowed to watch Dr. Graham on television, and he would say, and there are millions of us today from Winnipeg, Manitoba, where the Holy Spirit is speaking and will give you literature. All you need is one address, Billy Graham, Minneapolis, Minnesota. Won't you come? The buses will wait.
I don't know what happened to my, stand here, but thank you all so much. I'm so honored to be here. What is this Highway 33 all about exactly? I rededicated my life about, 8 times last night. I think I learned about 5 new cuss words. I didn't say them, but I wrote them down. And gave them to Brother Jerry. He's going to say them later. I was listening to Steve sing, and honestly, is there anybody sings any better than that? And that girl that was with, I don't know where she's at now. She's probably out smoking. That's what most of them, most of them singers, they do that, you know. But I was just sitting back there thinking, you know, I mean, who wouldn't like this? And Steve said it, and I've said it. We're the only group of people in the world that have anything to be happy about.
That's right.
And yet we spend, listen, I wrote in my journal, and this is ringing a little bit, brother. I wrote in my journal, if we don't enjoy our faith, we will never attract others to it.
Amen.
Who would ever want what some of us have? When I pastored in Florida, there's this lady, and I'd see her every week, and she's one of those gals just made a career out of being unhappy. Do you know what I'm talking? You probably got a couple of those here. And she said, Pastor, you know what I don't like? And I said, yeah. You don't like anything. You're going to hate heaven because you're not going to have anything to complain about. She said, well, you need to know this. My husband Earl and I are praying about leaving this church. And I said, well, you need to know that. That makes two of us. I've been praying you'd leave too. Won't you quit getting my hopes built up and just... Do you know what happened last week? Okay, so at the tape table last week, there's some folks coming by picking up some DVDs and some bracelets for stocking stuffers. And this lady, she was all wadded up about something because they hadn't let her sing. And I heard her, she was saying to the... Several people have asked me to sing. Nobody ever asked me anymore. I don't get to sing in my own church. And I thought, there's a reason for that, ma'am. You can't sing. And I love those folks. And I sing for the Lord. Well, why have I got to hear it then? It's for the Lord. And she got a little huffy with me. She said, if I were your wife, and I thought, I would rather be trapped in a steam room with the village people. I wouldn't be married to you for one day. She said, I'd put poison in your coffee. I said, if I was your husband, I'd drink it. Sometimes you just, sometimes you have to help people. You have to. But I'm honored. I'm just really honored to be here. I'm thankful. It's been a tough week. It's been a tough week, hasn't it, y'all? Little boys and girls and teachers lost their lives. And it all screams, Jesus is coming. Amen. My little girl, unknown to me, one of my twins, I got a call, emergency surgery. They found a mass, and thankfully, it was removed and it was not cancerous. But my sister-in-law, Connie, my brother's wife, she had surgery Monday, and the news was not good. I guess your appendix is an odd place to have cancer. Appendiceal cancer, they said like less than 1%. And doctor said we tried to get the tumor out, but it was like trying to take Jell-O out with a fork. It's everywhere. And I tell you, I'd really like for you all to pray for her. Just remember her. You know, if Jesus can walk past the tomb of his dead friend and speak life into a corpse.
Yes.
And say, come forth. Listen, he can heal cancer.
Yes, he can.
I believe that. I believe it with all my heart. I won't be long or boring because I've been in those services. I'm trying to think the way you are right now. Steve's going, I don't know why church has to be long. And you're all going, dear Heavenly Father, we will never beat the Methodist or the Chinese buffet. And I'll tell you why you won't, because they have an underground tunnel, them Methodists. Methodists come to church to go home. They back into their parking spot so they can fly out. And I love the buffet. I mean, I'll be honest. I was at the buffet. I'm going today. But I was standing under the sign that said buffet. I was looking at the word buffet, and it's buffet. Big, ugly, fat folks eating together. Buffet. There I was. I'm standing right under there. I kind of look like the poster child for it. You know what? They got a swimming hole where I'm staying at here, indoor swimming hole. I put my bathing suit on last night, went to pool. I'm not wasting that. I'm getting in there. And I caught a glimpse of myself. I resemble a busted can of biscuits is what it looks like. You know that water displacement thing? I did a cannonball, and they're having to refill the pool this morning. I thank you for coming. I hope you come back tonight. We're not coming, Harold. We did not come to church to laugh. Well, you picked the wrong day today then. Believe me, Harold's living with you. He needs a laugh, I promise you. If you have your Bible, I want you to turn to Deuteronomy chapter 30. And a man said to me the other day, he says, I believe in God. I just don't believe in organized religion. And, you know, I don't think my church's teachings were wrong or incorrect. I just think if we were doing what we were supposed to do, I don't believe people would say that. Yeah. And to be honest, I'm 55 years old. I am not as concerned as much at this point in my life in failing as I am in succeeding in something that doesn't really matter. Yeah. Do you understand what I'm saying? At the end of the day, God doesn't need us, but he wants us. Yeah. We need him, but most of us don't want him. God says in our text today, just very simply this, you can be blessed or you can be cursed. Yeah. Yes, sir. Blessings come from obedience.
Yes, sir.
Curses come from disobedience. It's like parents. You know, I see it all the time. You let your kids talk to you at 2 like you are subservient to them.
Come on now.
Y'all need to hear this for real, for real. If you can't control a 2-year-old, you don't have a prayer when they're 12. Huh?
Come on.
My buddy Dave is a school teacher. How many school teachers are here? Boy, these are the heroes as far as I'm concerned. These teachers, give them a... how many of your teachers, again, hold your hand up. Yeah, I just saw it. If my teacher looked like you, I'd have went to class. She's pretty. My teachers look like me, and they were women.
Miss Hubshire used to smoke Luckies, and she'd come after lunch, and she sounded like Pearl out the laundromat. She had that breath.
Oh, well, and what? I don't even mean to say this, but why is it people with the worst breath always have a secret?
Hi.
Oh, not yet. Keep blowing that on me and we will be. My buddy Dave told me some dude stood up in his class, my buddy Dave, the teacher, some dude stood up in his class and said, yo, man, you ain't my mom's, you ain't my dad, you know what I'm talking about? You know what I'm talking about? I ain't sitting there. See? Now, I'm from Kentucky. We're neighbors. West Virginia, Kentucky, we've got a lot of the same kind of people. Our folks don't roll that way. Huh? You seen these young thugs fight today? Come on, man, hit me, man. Come on, hit me, man. What's up? What's up? What's up? I'm from Eastern Kentucky. It's on, brother. We don't do any of that. Huh? That boy would have stood up in my class and said, yo. I'd have lost my job that day. I was raised different. If I got in trouble at school, I was in more trouble when I got home. Not your kids. If your kids get in trouble at school, you're down at the schoolhouse yelling at the teacher. I need to see somebody. Who been messing with Dontavius and Quadravian? I need to talk to somebody up in here. No, you need to tase them. Need to tase them. I wish teachers had tasers. I wish they made them for toddlers, like a toddler taser, a teen taser. So you ain't gonna clean your room up here? Come over here. I got a little something for you. And by the way, you're gonna see where all this laughter's going to, because laughter's like anesthesia. What you don't realize is you're being anesthetized right now. Because I'm fixing to gut you. Or as we say, I'm fin to. Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 19. I'm reading from the New Living Translation. I want you to watch and listen very carefully. Today I have given you the choice between life and death, between blessings and curses. Now I call on heaven and earth to witness the choice that you make. By the way, look this way, folks. Some of y'all need to quit blaming everybody else for where you are in life.
I had a dysfunctional childhood.
Take a number. Huh? Huh?
Yes.
My mom used to talk to the plants. She might have smoked some of them. My mom talks to the dog today and asks the dog questions. What are you barking at? It's a dog, Mom. She asked the dog like she expects the dog to go,
"Well, you know there was someone cutting through the backyard."
It's not going to do that. Some of y'all don't laugh very much, so you get it. So it's kind of nice, ain't it? Today I've given you the choice between life and death, between blessings and cursings. Now look, I call on heaven and earth to witness the choice that you make. Oh, that you, and underline these two words, would choose life. Those three words, would choose life, so that you and your descendants, King James says, your seed or your children, might live. You can make this choice by loving the Lord your God, obeying Him, and committing yourself firmly to Him. Listen to this. This is the key to your life. And if you love and obey the Lord, you will live long in the land that the Lord swore to give your ancestors, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I want to give you just the Cliff Notes version, if you don't mind. I'm going to take you very quickly, but I want you to look this way. I have a daughter, Heidi, and I have a daughter, Holly. Those are my twins. They're 27. My oldest daughter's Heather. She's going to be 32. I have three grandkids, which are God's reward to us for not killing our kids when they were teenagers. My daughter Holly had an aneurysm when she was a little girl. Holly today, 27 years old, she doesn't walk, she doesn't talk, she's fed through a tube. You've seen little kids like this. She lives on a ventilator. Every breath, someone, a machine takes for her. She has no purposeful movement, she's blind, but she can hear. She's never given us any idea that she even understands what we're saying, and she now lives in a nursing home. And all I can tell you is every time I leave there, I don't know what people without Christ do. It's hard enough even with Christ. Does that make sense? And I left the other day, and I just thought, you know, God, I would have never imagined going to see my daughter in a nursing home. That, you know, it's usually the other way around. Your kids come to see you. And Holly just lives a very frail and fragile life. Well, I've been preaching now for 35 years, and a lot, and of course, Holly is 27. So a lot of people around the world, Pastor said he heard me on K-Love the other day. I have a radio show. It's just a minute long called For Real, but it's on radio all over the country. Well, this lady, her and her husband met me after church. We did revival meetings. We start on Sunday and we go through Wednesday or Friday. This lady comes to me and she says, "Hey, look, my son thinks you're Elvis." And I said, "Well, he's really wrong." She said, "No, he loves you. He's got every one of your DVDs. He's got every one of your CDs. And he watches him to the point, the nurses." And when she said nurses, I thought he must be. And sure enough, he's in an institution. She said, "You're going to be here through the Wednesday." I said, "Yes, ma'am." She said, "Would there be any way you could visit him?" I said, "You know, as a matter of fact, I will. I'll go by before I leave, and I'll go by." And this was Sunday night. And I said, "I'll go by and see him before I leave on Wednesday." I'm driving to the motel, and God, the Holy Spirit, just convicts me because I think, what if something happens to him and I don't get to go see him? So I decided to go right then. And I walked in the room and he, clapping that I'm there. I sat on the bed and just, he cried and he'd talk. And I'd stayed about an hour, and I was getting ready to leave, and when I stood up to leave, he cut the biggest caper. I thought, I've hurt his feelings, or I've said something, and because he hated to see me go, and I hated to leave. But she said, the mother, she says, oh, no, she said, he's just, you didn't say anything about his picture. Well, over his bed was a picture of him in a formal. So he was either going to the prom, it was a senior prom or something. I don't know what it was, a senior dance or something. But he was dressed up and as a good-looking kid, incredibly good-looking boy. You didn't say anything about his picture. And I saw it when I came in the room, but I didn't go stare at it. She said, take a look at his, he wants you to see his picture. So I went to the picture, and there's this picture of this handsome young guy, but underneath is this little plaque. And the little plaque says, take a look at me, and it has an arrow pointing up at the picture. Take a look at me, aren't I the sharp-dressed man? Now take a look below, which pointed to his bed. This is what happens when you drink and drive. I wear this on my wrist. The teacher last week, she bought 100 of these. She wants every student in her class to have it. Stocking stuffers, dads, fathers. It's the message this morning. You are only one choice away from a different life. You're only one choice away. You are one step from stupid. You are one hot whisper away from a bad choice. Yes, sir. Or you are one step towards life eternal. You are one choice away from making Jesus the Lord of your life. What's problematic about church is there are people here this morning. You got your hands in the air. You got people thinking you got God all over you. But your Saturday night don't match your Sunday morning. You got a whole different life. I've been preaching 35 years. 4 years ago, I went off the rails on the crazy train. And I became somebody I never thought I'd ever be. Sleeping around, living in sin. And by the way, when the Bible says the way of the transgressor is hard, I don't know why people don't believe that. But aren't you thankful for grace? Aren't you thankful for mercy? I listen, that 16-year-old girl who comes to church pregnant, she don't need to hear what a whore she is. She needs to hear, you still have a future with God. That's what she needs to hear. That man battling the addiction of methamphetamine, and by the way, crack, that'll call your name. You can be clean and straight and out of nowhere. That stuff will call your name. But you know what? You're only one choice away from a different life. You decide, listen, I've had enough of this. I want to make Jesus the Lord of my life. But what I don't get, and come on now, what I don't get is you see it, a guy the other day. I'm watching this dude come in with his girlfriend. He cannot keep his hands off her. And I'm looking, and there's mom and dad sitting there going, aren't they a cute couple? Listen, do you not think they're having sex? I mean, for real, for real. If they're doing that in the broad daylight, can I get a, I know that's right? My 16-year-old is dating. Write this down. If your 16-year-old is dating, you are a nut. You're a nut. Write it down. I said it. It might be on YouTube. No, in reality, I told a lady the other day, she says, well, my 14-year-old's dating. That's the problem. Why in the world would you let a 14-year-old girl go out with this hormone hurricane? Huh? Well, he's not saved, but she's trying to win him to Christ. Really? Really? Nowhere in the Bible does it talk about missionary dating. Your boyfriend is not your mission field. When you go to the barn to milk cows and you leave, those cows don't smell like you.
So what are you like saying?
It's pretty hard to witness to a guy you're sleeping with. You're going to tell your boyfriend he needs Jesus? What, to be like you? You just had sex with him. I mean, really? Hey, folks, can we just kind of really get to it? 1 John 3:8 says, he that practices sin is of the devil. 1 John 3:9, whosoever is born of God does not practice sin. It doesn't mean we don't sin. But it does mean if you are saved, sin is not the practice of your life. There are people in this building, you've been having an extramarital affair for 2 years. You've got a secret life on the internet. And if you're taking notes, you ought to write this down. If your sin don't find you out, you'll be the first person in the whole world. Amen. You'll be number one. Amen. Your sin's going to find you out. Why don't you today just make that one choice? Why don't you today say, Lord, I don't care what everybody else is doing. I love to be with Steve. Steve and I probably did 50 or 60 dates. One of the things we're doing next year, I'm tired of going in for just one little day. I want to preach. Let's have an old-fashioned revival. Let's get back and preach the stars down. Let's have it. Hey, people won't come these days. They come to our meetings. They pack the place out. You want to know why, folks? People need to know you still have a future with God. You're one choice away from a different life. There are people, this lady says to me the other day, she says, this man that I'm dating, he so mistreats me. He's so unkind. He cusses at me. Hey, write this down. Don't complain about what you permit. Amen. If you allow it to happen, don't complain about it. I mean, seriously? Y'all got kids that tell you what to do. Some of you are afraid of your kids.
I don't know what to do with my son.
Send him to my house. They're not even thugs. They're like thuglets, like little chicklets. See, I grew up, you don't hit women. You understand that?
Yeah.
Ever. Right. I'm 55 years old. I'm 6'3", 300, and none of your business. But I'm at the 7-Eleven the other day, that great place. I'm putting gas in at $3.51 a gallon. Yeah, I paid $2.96 the other day. What are y'all doing up in here at $3.55? Y'all need to move. Gas prices are crazy here. So I'm at the 7-Eleven putting gas in my car. And there's one of these little shaved bird thugs, is what I call them. One of them little white guys that want to act like he's from South Central up in there. You know what I'm talking about? Look like a little shaved bird. Got his head cocked all sideways. And he's got, it's either his girlfriend or his wife, and he's got her by the throat, and he's got his fists like this. He said, I will blankety blank. I said, ho, 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 ho. What you gonna do, big man? I said, if you'll just... don't make me go Medea on you. If you will just let me get to you. I put the pump back. I started running as fast as I could get there. What you gonna do? I'm coming. You know what he did? Little punk. See, you better run. Because you need to know if I get a hold of you, I don't mind going back to prison. You don't hit a girl.
No.
I don't think God expects you to stay with a man that's hitting you.
That's right. Come on.
Amen.
So don't complain about what you permit. I don't believe God expects you to live with a man that's cheating on you. By the way, I don't believe God expects you to live with a woman that's cheating on you. Huh? You're only one choice away from a different life. One choice. I have a DVD out there. It's a message called One Step from Stupid. Somebody said, he's sitting right next to me. Stupid is right here. Jerry told me the other day, he says, I don't go to church anymore because of the hypocrites. That's why I don't go. I'd rather go to church with a few of them than go to hell with all of them. If you don't like hypocrites, you're not going to dig hell at all because they're all going to be there. I want to ask you about your choices. Look this way. Let me kind of wrap, and it is hot. What are y'all, what's the temperature up in here? Y'all need to open some doors or something. I'm about to pass out. By the way, I want you to laugh, but you know what? I want you to hear this. Every single day we make choices. God says you can live blessed or you can live cursed. Blessings come from obedience. Curses come from disobedience. So the other day, I'm standing at the cemetery, getting ready to bury a young boy. He said, hey, Mom and Dad, come down here. You got to see this. Very animated. Mom and Dad, wherever they're at in the house, come in. Sit down on the couch in the living room. Sit down. You got to see this. They sat down. He said, I hate you. You're only one choice away. Every day, people make decisions. Now, folks, I want you to hear this. I have a message called Satanic Deceptions Regarding Salvation. You know, there are people here today, you say, I'm just not sure that... What, Jamey, what if I get saved and I'm already saved? You can't do that. But if you could... I'd rather be saved twice than lost once. Some of you have a good reason to doubt. And the honest is, saved people don't live the way you live. Again, it's not that we don't mess up, because we do. I'm not talking about the whoops. I'm not talking about the sin and God the Holy Spirit just whips you and you go, God, I'm sorry. But I'm talking about you that have you have a different life. Nothing's sacred. You can leave a service like this and you can go sit down in front of a computer and go to a world that's dark. I'm as much a man as anybody here, but I'm going to tell you, never been to a strip club. Never been to a strip club. You want to know why I've never been to a strip club? I'm going to tell you why. Because I'm a dad of three daughters.
Come on now.
And all I can see is my daughter up there in some common lowlife sitting there lusting after my daughter. See, I'm going to prison if I get you. Do you know what? You'll do that on your wife or your husband. And it doesn't bother you. This guy the other day, he's had a... been married to the same gal 26 or 7 years. He's had a homosexual affair with a man he works with for 20 years. He that practices sin is of the devil. Whoever is born of God does not practice sin. For his seed remaineth in him, and he cannot sin continually or habitually because he is born of God. By this the children of God are manifest, and the children of the devil. Whosoever doeth not righteousness is not of God, neither is he that loveth not his brother. That's pretty strong. Would you bow your head with me? I love you, folks. Thank you. This is a precious church. I needed the way of holiness today. I told Pastor Jerry, I stopped on the way. I asked a lady, I said, I'm trying to find the way of holiness. She said, I'm trying too also. I said, well, I think it's down here. You got to make a decision. Some of you are dating somebody, and you know what? You have no idea, but I mean, seriously, do you think that little of yourself? You're dating a guy that's not saved. Let me give you the 411 on this. That's like giving a builder two different sets of architectural drawings. Two cannot walk together unless they're agreed. Light doesn't have fellowship with darkness. Do you understand? I want to ask you this question. If you died today, are you 100% sure that you're going to heaven? I mean, if you died today, are you 100% sure that you're going to heaven? I mean, do you know that you know that you know that you know? I wonder how many friends today would just hold up your hand and say, you know what, Jamey? Wow, I listened to the message. I'll be honest with you, I needed it today. I needed to laugh a little bit today. I needed to smile. But Jamey, I'll be honest with you, God spoke to my heart. There's some things in my life. Jamey, I am not 100% sure that I'm going to heaven. But I really do care enough about my soul to ask you to pray for me. I wonder how many of you would take your hand high as you can, hold it straight up in there and just say, Jamey, I am not 100% sure that I'm going to heaven, but I really do care enough about my soul to ask you to pray for me. And you might even say, you know, Jamey, there was a time in my life I thought I was saved, but I'm not sure now. But today when you pray, would you pray for me? How many of you right now in the name of Jesus would take your hand, hold it straight up in the air and say, and God bless you, 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 you. How many others? Just put, how many others? How many others would take you in? God bless you. How many of you say, Jamey, I did not raise my hand the first time, but on second thought, I want to get in on this. I know the real me. I know who I really am, and I'm not 100% sure that I'm going to heaven, but I care enough about my soul to ask you to pray for me. How many others would just take your hand? Would you hold it straight up in the air and say, include, and God bless you, and you, 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 and you, you, and you, and God bless you. How many others? Would everybody, listen, would everybody that raised their hand look right here at me? Would every one of you who raised your hand look at me? Here's what you said, Jamey. I'm not 100% sure that I'm going to heaven, but I care enough about my soul to ask you to pray for me. That's what I want to do. I'd be honored to do that. But I don't want you to sit there. Every person Jesus called, he called publicly. Did you know that? I'm going to count to three. If you raised your hand, I want you to come. And I want you just to kneel right here, right here next to me. If you're not able to kneel, just stand. And if you need a chair, we'll pick up one. Are you ready? Two. Three. Come on. Just take a knee. Amen. Come on, man. It's your day today, son. Come on down. I want you to come as close. Come right here. Come right up here. I want you to look right this way. I've prayed prayers that I didn't mean. I want to tell you what the word is today. This is the word. The word is disingenuous, which just means not genuine. If I tell you I love you and you're my friend, but I don't mean that, it doesn't matter that I said that. Do you understand? People say things all the time they don't mean. That's why I wear this all the time. I'm only one choice away from a different life. There's a lady from the church, and I'm just going to give you this. A lady from the church broke down about 2 miles from her house, pouring rain. She said, preacher, can you take me home? I said, no, sure can't. You want to know why? Because people want to believe the worst about you anyway. And so I said, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll sit right here. I've got a cell phone. And I'll call your husband or your dad. We'll get somebody here, and I'll wait till they get here. I'm only one choice away from a different life. But you can say anything you want, but if you don't mean it, it doesn't matter. But you mean it. I want you to pray with me today from your heart. Pray this with me. If you mean this with all of your heart, God will save you. He'll forgive you. He will keep you. He will bless you. But you have to mean this. Are you ready? Pray with me. I want you to pray this out loud. Dear Lord, I know that I'm a sinner. And I cannot save myself. But I know you can. And that's why I came. With my mouth, I confess. In my heart, I believe that Jesus died for me. And I place my faith and I place my trust in you, Jesus, and what you did for me on the cross of Calvary. I accept you, Jesus, as my Lord and my Savior. Please accept me. This is my humble prayer. In Jesus' name. Amen. Now I want you, if you would, if you meant that prayer, I want you just to stand to your feet. And I want you to face that crowd. Ladies and gentlemen, this is why we come. All of these men and women today ask Jesus to be their Lord and to be their Savior. Hey, all of you who prayed, look this way. All of you who prayed, look this way. The next thing you need to do is be baptized. Somebody says, well, I was already baptized. Oh, no. Baptism comes after salvation.
Yes, sir.
So it's time for you to get your baptism on the right side of your salvation. Yeah. If you meant what you prayed today, what happened before was that you got wet.
Yeah.
And by the way, that's why some of you perpetually doubt your salvation. Because you've never been scripturally baptized.
Come on, brother.
Baptism comes after salvation.
Yes, sir. Yes.
And the reason you doubt is if you've not been willing to do the first thing God asks you to do after you get saved, you're naturally going to wonder whether you meant what you prayed.
Amen.
I want all y'all to go back to your chairs, but I want you all to give him a hand clap and give him a hand clap of praise.